Good evening to one and all. Now welcome back to the today's session. Now in the last class we discussed about the half wave rectifier. Now today is the continuation of the last class. That is, today we are going to discuss the full wave rectifier. Now we will discuss about the full wave rectifier, followed by we will obtain the relationships of the DC current, RMS currents, DC voltage, RMS voltage. Now what is the efficiency of the rectifier, what is the ripple factor, form factor, peak factor, and all these things we are going to see in the last class in what way we have done for the half wave rectifier. The today's class we are going to see for the full wave rectifier. Okay, now we are moving on to the today's topic, that is a full wave rectifier. Okay, now just once again I'm reviewing the last class. There only the front slide, first slide I will I'm reviewing. Just I'm reviewing the simple what is the definition of rectifier and what is what the process actually is going to happen during the rectification process, and everything we will see in with the help of only single slide. Now a rectifier is an electrical device, you know, that converts alternating current, and that is which periodically reverses the direction to a direct current. This direct current is not the pure DC current, which is the pulsating DC current. Now this process we are calling as a rectification. A rectifier is an electrical device which converts alternating current into the pulsating DC current. Now see, rectifier input is your AC, output is nothing but your pulsating DC. Even though we are having the ripples in the output, but that is a DC value. Always remember, output of rectifier is your DC, input of rectifier is your AC. Whenever any term, if you are referring to the output, means output is always, it is a DC value. Now input means it is a AC value. Now rectifier circuit will offer the low resistance to the current in one direction and high resistance in the opposite direction. Okay, now rectifier converts the sinusoidal signal into the unidirectional flow, and there is a not pure DC, there is a pulsating DC. Now output of this rectifier, now we are correcting a filter circuit. Now the filter will remove all the ripples in the pulsating DC current, and it will produce a pure DC. Okay, now the combination of rectifier plus filter, now these two will convert alternating current AC into the pure form of your DC. Okay, now today we are going to see the full wave rectifier. And now there are two types of rectifiers are there. In the last class we already discussed, one is a half wave rectifier and second one is full wave rectifier. And in the full wave rectifier also with the bridge rectifier is there. Now bridge rectifier is also the one form of your full wave rectifier. Now what is a full wave rectifier? Now in the half wave rectifier, which is rectifying only half wave of the input signal, that means during the positive cycle, now it is rectifying the signal, and during the negative case, now the diode is becoming turned off. Now there is no current flowing through the diode. Ultimately it is zero current. Once again, for every every positive half cycle of the input signal, now it is rectified and it is obtained as the output. Only half wave is going to be rectified. Now coming to the full wave, but the efficiency of the half wave rectifier is very, very poor. Only 40.6% efficiency is there. The ripple factor is also very, very high. Now 1.21 is there. Now if you are seeing the half wave rectifier, now that is not suitable for the practical applications, because the maximum amount of power is not delivering to the load. Only 60% of power is going to be wasted. That is efficiency. Now in order to avoid that, now we are going for the next type of rectifier, that is a full wave rectifier. The name itself, it is saying it is a full wave rectifier. A complete wave is going to be rectified. Now how we can achieve the full wave rectification? With the help of a small modification in the circuit diagram. Instead of using the one diode, now we are connecting the two diodes in the circuit. Now these two diodes will not conduct parallelly. Now during the positive cycle, the one diode is going to conduct. In the negative cycle, second diode is going to conduct. That means, now I will show you with the help of circuit diagram, I will explain to you. Now in the full wave rectification, the current flow through the load is same direction for the both half cycle of the input AC. This can be achieved with the two diodes working alternatively. Okay, for one half cycle, one diode supplies the current to the load, and for the next half cycle, another diode will works. So like this, for the complete signal, first half cycle, the first diode will conduct, second diode will not conduct. During the second half cycle, second diode will conduct, first diode will not conduct. In this fashion, now it will supplies continuously the signal to the load. Okay, now see, this is a circuit diagram of your full wave rectifier. Now here, we are using the transformer type is center tap transformer we are using. I think people are aware of what is the difference between normal transformer and center tap transformer. Now center tap transformer, it is having the three terminals at the output side. It is producing two signals. In between these two, now this terminals is nothing but your positive and negative. Now this is a reference line. Now it is becoming negative and the positive. Okay, during the first cycle, now what is going to happen? Is there any problem? People are following the class? No, why? Yes, yes, yes. Okay. We'll move on to our topic. Okay, you don't know center tap transfer. Okay, you know, no problem. I will tell you. Explain that also. Okay, now what is the difference between normal transformer, center tap transformer is? Now in case of normal transformer, it has a primary winding is there. It has secondary winding is there. Now this is a normal transformer. If you are applying as a input as a AC signal, the output is also AC. Transformer input and output will be in secondary phase also. You are going to get AC signal. But it is only one signal you are going to, plus and minus, with respect to these two terminals. Now this is a signal you are going to obtain. Now that may be the step down transformer, step up transformer. Output will be the same AC signal you have. But in case of center tap transformer, now what is going to happen? It will produce the two signals with 90 degrees phase shift. Now see, if it is a first phase, now see, this is a neutral line. It has three terminals. Middle one is a three having. Now with respect to this line, now it will produce a signal. This is a positive terminal. This is a negative. It is becoming. It is one signal it is going to generate. Now during the second 90 degrees phase shift, now here it is having the positive is coming. Now this is a signal here. It is going to generate in the center tap transformer. You got the clear? Now in the normal transformer, now only one signal you are going to obtain at the output side. Now this is a only one signal you are going to obtain. Now that is considering as a positive to negative terminal. But in the center tap transformer, that it is producing the two signals. Now this, if you take this is a reference line, the first one is the normal signal it is you are going to obtain. In the second half, you are going to get the 90 degrees phase shift. That is, this is a phase shift, you are going to get the signal. Now this is a in the first cycle, now it is a normal signal you are getting. Here in this case, what is initially you are getting is a negative plate. Right. Now, during this case, now you connected the AC supply to this full wave rectifier. Now see, this is the diode D1 and this diode is D2. Now during the first half of the signal, now I am drawing here. Now the first one is, this is at the diode D1, this is a signal you are applying. At the diode D2, this is a signal you are applying. This is a signal we are applying to the diode D2. During the positive half of the signal, now which diode will conduct? Now this is a positive, now the diode D1 will conduct. Now diode D1 is getting the positive supply, the positive terminal here. This is in forward bias, diode D1 will be in reverse forward bias. Now coming to diode D2, now here negative peak is coming to the diode D2. Negative means it is a negative and positive terminals it is having. Now this is in reverse bias. Now during the positive half of the cycle, in reverse bias. That means D2 is going to be in off. During the second half of the cycle, now diode D1 is going to be off, gas peak is coming at the D2. Now for the positive applied voltages, now diode D2 will conduct. That means for every half of the cycle, now first half of the cycle, the diode D1 will conduct, D2 will be off. Now for second half of the cycle, D2 will conduct, D1 is going to be off. Now like this, for every cycle, that see this is from 0 to the first cycle, second, third, but it will not conduct in reverse direction. Output, rectified output is not in reverse way. See, whenever the diode is in forward bias, the current will flow. The maximum current will flow. This is current flow through the diode. Now this is due to your diode D1. Now this flow is due to D2. This is due to D1. And this is your due to T2. What is a half wave rectifier? In the half wave rectifier, during the positive cycle, diode D1 will conduct. Negative cycle, it is going to be zero. Now for the positive cycle, only whenever it is a positive cycle, now the diode D1 will conduct. Now in full wave rectifier, the complete wave is going to be rectified. Now the first initially the current is due to the D1 diode, it is in forward bias. The next cycle the current is due to your diode D2, this because D2 is in forward bias. For the third cycle, it is due to D1 and D2, it will continuously, it is going to rectifying the full wave of the signal, input signal. Okay, now see, we'll see the statements here. Now circuit has two diodes, D1 and D2, and a center type of transformer. During the positive half of the cycle, diode D1 will conduct, and during the negative half of the cycle, diode D2 will not conduct. Now same thing, it can be seen that current through the load, first initially during the D1 conducting, the current flowing through, this is the D1. During the second cycle, the current is flowing through the D2, that means through the load, at a time, only through one diode only current is going to be flow. That means always current is flowing through the load resistance RL. Now this is a simple full wave rectifier. Now there is a problem with this full wave rectifier because usage of transformer is bulky and it is heavy also. Now we can avoid the usage of transformer with the help of four diodes. Now that configuration we are calling as the bridge rectifier, that we will see here. Now what is a full wave rectifier? This bridge rectifier is also comes under full wave rectifier. Now what is the name we are calling as a bridge? Now if you are connecting the four diodes in the bridge fashion, now take it, this is a bridge I am having. If you are connecting the four diodes as a bridge fashion, now this is the RL you are having. Now the same circuit will be performing the application like the center tap of transformer, same full wave rectifier. But why we are choosing this bridge rectifier? Here, no need of your center type of transformer is, we can eliminate here. Okay, now it consists of four diodes. What we can do, at a time only two diodes will be on. Now the current is flowing through this way, it is going to be happen. And now we will see, a bridge rectifier is not there in your syllabus. He is asking about a full wave rectifier. Now what is the main purpose of bridge rectifier? The bridge rectifier is also full wave rectifier. It will rectify the complete signal. Main importance of bridge rectifier is, now we can eliminate the center tap of transformer, because specially taking the center tap of transformer, it is specially for the rectification purpose, it is a heavy as well as a bulk also. Now it consists of four diodes instead of two diodes. The previously in the full wave rectifier we are using the two diodes, but instead of two, if you use the four diodes, now you can eliminate this center tap of transformer. How, we will see here. Now what is the full wave bridge rectifier we are having? Now during the positive cycle, what is going to happen? Now see the diode connection. Now if you are applying at this positive terminal here, the diode D1, the D2 will be forward bias, so D1 will be reverse bias. Now you are going to connect a circuit such a way that now all the four diodes will be, now at with respect to this point, one diode must be forward, one cathode must be connected, anode must be connected to this point. To this node, one anode, one cathode of the two diodes you are going to connect. Now here D1 is, you are connecting as negative terminal, you are connecting to this point, and D2 positive you are connecting here. Now that means you are connecting as the anode part and the cathode part you are connecting here. Now for the same this point, and now here also this is, now same negative, this is the cathode you are connecting to this point, anode you are connecting to this current. Now if you are combining these four resistors, it is forming as a bridge, that's why you are calling as a bridge rectifier. Now during the positive half of the cycle, what is going to happen? positive half of the cycle. Now this diode will be off. The D1 is in off. D2 is going to be in on, because for the positive cycle, the diode D2 will conduct. Okay. And now the same thing, the current is flowing to this D1 and it is flowing through this one. And once again, for this, now the D3 is going to be in forward bias, and so that the circuit will complete. See, at this point, the positive terminal is coming. The maximum current is coming through the diode, current flowing. Now, with respect to this current, it is going to be in off. D4 is in reverse bias. Now, the current will not flow through this path. The current will flow into the load resistance. And once again, it is flowing through the D3. D3 is, this is the forward bias case. That means D2, D3 will be in forward bias, so that one circuit will complete. The complete path is there, so that the current is flowing from one path to another path during the positive half of the cycle. Now see, what is the during the negative half of the cycle, what is going to happen? During the negative half of the cycle, now see, this is the negative, you are applying as the negative and positive here. For this negative half of the cycle, this negative and negative are applying, this D1 is going to be in forward bias. Now the current is flowing through this diode. Now this is a reverse bias. There is no current flowing through this. Now current is flowing through this branch. And once coming to this point, this is negative, and the negative and positive, this is the positive terminal you are having. Now this is also going to reverse bias. There is no current flowing through this. The current is flowing through the load resistance, and negative to negative, this is a forward bias, and this is a complete loop for the negative cycle of your input applied voltage. That means during the positive peak of the signal and the negative peak of the signal, there is a complete path from the one point to the another point. Now that's why here we can eliminate the center tap of transformer. Just with the help of two extra diodes, we can eliminate the need of your center tap of power transformer. Okay, now this is a simple bridge rectifier configuration. Now see, the analysis part for the bridge rectifier as well as the full wave rectifier, both are going to be same. Bridge rectifier is also comes under your full wave rectifier only. But the construction part is different. For the normal full wave rectifier, you are using the center tap transformer. Now for the bridge rectifier, you are not using center tap transformer. Instead of that, you are using two more extra diodes. These four diodes were connecting in the bridge fashion, so that you are obtaining the full wave rectification process here. Okay. Now this I explained just now. During the period T0 to T2, the diode D2 and D3 are conducting, while D1, D4 is in off state. Now this is the same positive peak you are getting here. Will conducting, and now during the negative T2 to T during this cycle, now what is going, which are the diodes it is conducting? This diode is conducting, this diode is conducting. So that the current is complete path is there. If you find the break in this path, the current will not flow, the circuit will not complete. It is not an incompletely circuit, but circuit is complete. Complete means current flow will take place from one end to the another end. Now this is a full wave bridge rectifier, the simple operation. Right, now we move on to the analysis part of the full wave rectifier. Now from this diagram, we can easily tell for the half wave rectifier, what are the analytical part you have done. For the same values, one more extra part you are adding. Now this is one half wave rectifier and the another half wave rectifier. The combination of two half wave rectifiers is nothing but your full wave rectifier. Now, all the expressions and all the formulae, whatever you are using for the half wave rectifier, the same thing is for the full wave rectifier also. But extra thing we are adding is, in case of half wave rectifier, current is flowing through only half of the cycle. But here, full wave rectifier, the second half also current is going to flow. That is a negative current generally. Okay? That we will see here. Now, a full wave rectifier converts AC signal into a pulsating DC voltage using both half cycles of the applied AC voltage. Now, in order to rectify both of the half cycles of the AC input, the two diodes are used in the circuit. The same thing I explained here. Okay, the two diodes are using the diodes to feed a common load RL with the help of a center tap transformer. Now, see here, this is a Vmax, the maximum voltage of signal you're getting. This is a Vmax. It's a positive, negative. This is a ground. Generally, center line is nothing but center tap. Center is nothing but your ground. Now these are the signals you are going to get. But center tap transformer will produce the 90 degrees phase shift signals. Just remember that. Okay, now this is a simple, the complete picture of your full wave rectifier. Now this is the input signal you are applying. Now, I1, what is I1? I1 is the current due to diode D1. Remember, there are two types, two currents are there here. One is I1 and second one is I2. What is the total current in the circuit? The addition of I1 plus I2 is nothing. This is, I think people are aware of the nodal analysis. Now at the common point, the number and the currents entering is equal to the currents leaving. I1, I2 both are entering. That means I1 plus I2 is equal to 0. The total current in the complete circuit, this is nothing but I1 plus I2. I1 is the current due to the diode D1 and I2 is the current due to the diode D2. Now see, now what is the current through the diode D1? Current through the diode D1, it will be available for us when 0 to pi, 2 pi to 3 pi, and you are having the same thing. The current alternative cycle series is available. Okay, what is the current through the diode? Now this is the missing cycles. Now D2 will conduct, now pi to 2 pi, next 3 pi to 4 pi, now here also we are going to get the diode through. It is a continuously. Now like this, if you are combining these two, I1 plus I2, the total current is nothing but, this is I1 plus I2 is, the, I think the last diagram is not visible to you people. So the last diagram is nothing but, I am drawing with the marker here. This is the first due to I1, addition of I2, and this is continuously, it is going to be rectified. This is a full wave rectifier. Now, in the full wave rectifier, the current, the complete, the total current is due to the current flowing through the diode D1 as well as the current flowing through the diode D2. Just remember the simple thing. Right, we'll go for the analysis part. Now, what is, we'll take a sinusoidal signal Vi, and now is normally Vi is nothing but Vm sine omega t. This like for the half wave rectifier, the same thing. But the current I1 through the diode D1 and the load RL is given by I1. When the I1 is flowing? During the first half of the signal. From the 0 to pi, current is flowing. That is Im sine omega t. Now, next one is pi to 2 pi, it is going to be 0. That means, the previously half wave rectifier, there is no I1 and I2. That is only I. I is equal to Im sine omega t for 0 to pi is equal to 0 for pi to 2 pi for half wave rectifier. For full wave rectifier, there are two types of currents are there, I1 and I2. I1 is current is flowing now 0 to pi and 2 pi to 3 pi, and next one is like this, alternative cycles it is going to flow. Now where Im, what is the maximum current? Im is equal to V by R. I is equal to V by R. In the last class we already seen, the Vm is nothing but your maximum voltage by R. What is R? Rf is the diode forward resistance plus the load resistance. This is the total resistance value. Now this is maximum current value, Im value. Now similarly, the current is I2 through the diode D2 and the load RL is given by, now for I2 is equal to 0 at the 0 to pi, now for pi to 2 pi, this current is the negative current, that is minus Im sin omega t. It is not plus Im sin omega t. Okay, now the total current is nothing but IL is equal to, IL is a load current flowing through the load resistance, that is equal to I1 plus I2, that is given by the current flowing through the diode D1 I1 and the current flowing through the diode D2, that is nothing but your I2. During the diode D1, the current will flow through the 0 to pi, and the second it is going to be 0. Through the diode D2, now it is I2 is equal to 0 for 0 to pi, it is minus Im sin omega t for the pi to 2 pi. Now just remember these two current expressions. Right, we'll come for the first one. What is the average current? The average current IDC is given by 1 by 2 pi into integral of 0 to 2 pi IDT. Generally, the expression is 1 by 2 pi, that is equal to integral of 0 to 2 pi IDT. But here, what is your total current I? My total current I is equal to I1 plus I2. I1 plus I2. Okay. Now, the I1 plus I2 is, I1 is nothing but I1 d omega t, I2 d omega t. Your I1 is equal to 0 to pi only, it is going to exist. Now, that is Im sin omega t d omega t. For the next interval, pi to 2 pi, it is going to be 0. Now, for the second part, now second part also, 1 by 2 pi, 0 to pi, for the first part, I2 is equal to 0, second part is equal to minus Im sin omega t. Now, just you take first one is Im by pi, second one is Im by pi, the total value is 2 Im by pi. Now, see, for a half wave rectifier, what is your DC current? The average DC current is given by IDC is equal to Im by pi. This for the half wave, 1 Im by pi you are getting. For the full wave, how many you are going to get like this? 2 Im by pi. Remember, If 2im by pi is nothing but for the full wave rectifier, im by pi is nothing but your half wave rectifier. Okay. Now this is the DC current value. The total this IDC is given by 2im by pi. Now substitute the values for the im. Now this is a DC current. Now what is the IDC value? Maximum current im is equal to. Now here already we have seen what is im is equal to. Now vm by rf plus rl. Now come here. Now what is your IDC is equal to? Now substitute in the values in the im, you are getting IDC is equal to 2 by pi. Take the 2 by pi is aside. What is your im is equal to? Vm by rf plus rl. See, this derivation is similar to the half wave rectifier. There is, it is not a new concept. Whatever we expressions we used for the half wave rectifier, the same thing for the full wave rectifier. But only the thing is, in the full wave rectifier, the total current is due to the I1 and I2, due to diode D1 and diode D2. That's why whatever half wave you are getting, everything will be doubles for the full wave. That is the only difference. Okay, this is a DC current. Now go through the previous half wave rectifier presentation, then you will get a clarity. Now this is the DC current is given by, average DC current is 2im by pi. Okay, what is the average DC voltage? VDC is equal to IDC into RL. Now what is your IDC value? Your IDC is equal to 2Vm by pi into RF plus RL. Now same thing, your submit IDC is equal to 2Im by pi into RL. Now take the 2 by pi as common. Now what is IM? IM is equal to Vm by RF plus RL, and this RL is at this part. Now consider, always the load resistance is very very high compared to the forward resistance. Now that's why our VDC is given by 2Vm by pi. Now same thing we are discussing for the half wave rectifier. For the half wave rectifier, that is IDC, DC current is given by Im by pi. Im by pi. Now for the full wave rectifier, it is given by Im by 2Im by pi. For the full wave rectifier, 2Im by pi. Now same thing for the DC voltage, average DC voltage for half wave rectifier is given by, that is Vm by pi. Now here, now in this case, what is the full wave rectifier? That is 2Vm by pi. That is doubling the half wave rectifier. That is a simple value. Okay, the next one is the RMS current. Now we are going to see IRMS value as well as VRMS value. Okay, now what is the RMS value? RMS value is nothing but integral of 0 to pi, root mean square value. Square root of root mean square value, I square d omega t. Here I is nothing but you are having same I1 plus I2. Now I1 is, first you take the I1 square d omega t plus I2 square d omega t. Now if you, that means if you solve, if you simplify all those things, finally you are going to get Im by root 2. Now here nothing is hidden to you. This is a simple integral part we are having. Now it is very easy for you people. Now you can solve line by line also. I think no need to explain, because today our class is only 1 hour we are having. Within the 1 hour, last 20 minutes is allocated for only quiz part. Only 40 minutes is there for today's explanation part. Okay. Now like the same thing. Now in case of half wave rectifier, what is IRMS value? IRMS for half wave rectifier is Im by, what is the value? Im by 2. Now in case of your full wave rectifier, that is Im by root 2. Just remember these two. Sir, you said for the DC average value, that is a double, not 2Im by 2. Here also we are going to get 2Im. Now see, average current is different, the RMS current is different. DC current is, output is the DC, RMS value is nothing but the AC current. So that's why, now IR, just remember, don't go, blindly go it. Now just remember the formula. Now IRMS for the half wave rectifier is Im by 2. Full wave rectifier, it is Im by root 2. Now IRMS is equal to Im by root 2. Now in the similarly, what is the VRMS value? Now VRMS is equal to IRMS into RL. Now VRMS is equal to Vm by root 2. Now like the similarly we are having, now IRMS as well as VRMS. RMS current and RMS voltage. In case of half wave rectifier, now that is given by Im by 2, and half wave rectifier it is VRMS is Vm by 2. Now in case of full wave rectifier, it is given by Im by root 2, and this is for the VRMS, RMS voltage, it is given by Vm by root 2. So remember these expressions. Okay. The next term is we are having the efficiency. What is efficiency? This is a rectifier. Output of the rectifier is your DC. The input is AC. Now, the power at the output DC, the DC power delivered at the output side, that means the power DC power to AC power is nothing but your rectifier efficiency. Now, for a half-wave rectifier, we calculate the efficiency of half-wave rectifier, that is 40.6 only. Now, we will calculate for the full-wave rectifier, how much we are going to get. Now, what is the DC power? The DC power PDC is equal to I square DC. See here, this is not IDC. I square DC into RL. Okay, here it is not visible to you. Now, when we are referring the presentations, just have a look at this single line. Now, what is I square DC? What is IDC value for a full wave rectifier? IDC is equal to 2IM by pi now. 2IM by pi. Now, this is whole square, I square. That is 4IM square by pi. This is a 4IM square by pi into RL. Now, what is the AC value, PAC value? I square RMS into RL plus RF. Now, what is IRMS value? IRMS is equal to IM by root 2. Okay. Now, this is becoming your IM by root 2 whole square. Now, see. Now, see, this is not, this is IM by root 2, this is IM by root 2 whole square. It is becoming IM square by root 2 whole square is nothing but your 2 into RL plus RF. Efficiency is given with PDC by PAC. Now, what is this value? 4 into IM square into RL by pi square. This is a DC power delivered. What is AC power? 2 by IM square. This is not RMS. Just make a note of this. This is a IDC, IM this is maximum. Okay, maximum current. Now this reverse this 2 by IM square into RL plus RF. Okay, now if you are solving these two, you are getting 4 into 8 by pi square, take the common here. IM square is going to be cancelled. Now RL by 1 plus RL plus RF you are getting. Now we take the RL as a common here. Now 8 by pi square into 1 plus RF by RL. Now generally, now to calculate the maximum efficiency, the RF by RL factor should be 0. Now if you are making this RF parallel factor to 0, what is efficiency we are getting? 81.2% efficiency. Now for half wave rectifier, it is 40.6 only. Now for full wave rectifier, efficiency was double. Now that was came to your 81.2%. Now that's why in the full wave rectifier, maximum 81.2 means 82% of load is delivered into the load resistance band. Now that's why in the practical applications, we will prefer only the full wave rectifier, not the half wave rectifier. Next part is nothing but ripple factor. What is the ripple factor is given by? IRMS by IDC whole square minus 1 or VRMS by VDC whole square minus 1. These expressions are the same for a half wave rectifier also. Just we are substituting the values. What is IRMS value? IM by root 2 by IDC value is 2IM by pi. Now if you are reversing this, pi by 2IM whole square minus 1. If you are solving this, what is the ripple factor? It is 0.48. Now, what is the ripple factor for your half wave rectifier? 1.21. This ripple factor will tell us at the output side, ripples present in the, that means already pulsating DC we are getting at the output of rectifier. The pulses, the ripples, very less number of ripples are there compared to half wave rectifier. The half wave rectifier, it is 1.21 is very large compared to this one. Now, the ripples content that is shown by the ripple factor. Okay. Now, the ripple factor is very less for the full wave rectifier also. This is also one of the advantages for us. Now, regulation. In the last class also, one of you people asked about the regulation. They asked about, discuss about the regulation part. But generally, this regulation, we are going to see for the full wave rectifier, maximum thing. What is the regulation? Percentage of regulation we are going to calculate. The percentage of regulation is the no load. If you are not removing the load, what is the no load voltage minus full load voltage by full load voltage, VFL into 100. Expression is there, I will show you there. Now, that is nothing but the regulation. How much it is regulated? That means the converting the signal. Now, the variation of VDC with respect to IDC for a full load rectifier is given by, see, the simple VDC value is V is equal to I into R. It is a DC voltage, that's why DC current into load resistance. What is IDC for full wave rectifier? 2IM by pi into RL. Okay. Now, this is the 2 into, what is IM value? Maximum current IM is given by VM by RF plus RL. This is from the first slide. Now, this is VM by RF plus RL. This is a part of your IM I have taken. Now, see, here people are going to confuse. What is the thing? The same expression is there for your half-wave rectifier also. Sir, from where we are getting this part? From where you are getting this part? Now I am taking the 2 Vm by pi as common. Okay. Now remaining part is you are having RL by RF plus RL. Now how to represent this single term? Now this term I can represent 1 minus RF by RF plus RL. Now see this part. Now this is the represent. I am representing this part in this fashion. Because to isolate these two terms, I want to write in terms of your DC current. See, take the numerator, take the LCM here. This is RL plus RF, RL plus RF minus RF, minus RF plus RF is cancelled. Now total you are getting RL by RL plus RF. Same term you are going to get. Okay, now this one is multiplied the 2 Vm by pi. Now 2 Vm by pi into RF by RL plus RF. Already we know that. What is that value? RL by RF, the Vm by RL plus RF term is nothing but IDC value. What is IDC value? IDC is equal to 2 Vm by pi into RF plus RF. This is the term you are getting. See, I will remove all this color. See this term, what is this term? 2Vm by pi into RF plus RL. This is nothing but your, this value is your IDC value. In terms of load resistance, you are writing. Okay, if you want to see, I will show you. See. See, this is IDC value, no? See. What is the VDC value? 2 by 2 Vm into 2 by pi. Sorry, I will go one step. See. What is this IDC value? IDC is 2 Vm by pi into RF plus RL. Now, in order to represent in terms of IDC, I have written like this. See, this is 2 Vm by pi into RL plus RF is your IDC current multiplied by the RF value. Now that means the variation of this VDC with respect to IDC we are going to find out. But that's it. To get this IDC factor, I am rewriting this term in terms of this value. Keep it aside. This VDC is nothing but is a no load. This is a value with load it is having, because we are considering the RL into this. This is a full load. With load, this is a DC voltage. Now, what is the percentage of regulation? See, this actually, if the lab is there to you people, actually, we are having the parallelly the EDC lab to everyone. ADE theory part and the ADE lab is there. In the ADE lab, first part is the PN junction diode, the Jenner diode, and the rectifiers also, one experiment is there. Now, all these expressions we are going to use in our actual laboratory. Now, with the help of practical, you will get the full clarity. But due to this scenario, the practicals are not able to conduct. That's why you people will have some little bit confusion about this, all the derivation. The expression for percentage of regulation is no load voltage to full load voltage by full load voltage into 100 is a regulation factor. Now, what is the no load value? No load means without load, that is 2 Vm by pi, that is a direct DC voltage. With the full load, that is the previously what we derived is a full load by the full load factor into 100. That is a percentage of regulation. Now what we can write this simply? Now simply this minus minus is going to be cancelled. 2 Vm by pi, 2 Vm by pi is going to be cancelled. Minus and minus becoming plus IDC into RF pi. Now the simple value, this is IDC into RF. And now this complete term is nothing but you can represent as IDC into RF. Okay, now you are cancelling this IDC by IDC. Now what is the percentage of regulation? Forward resistance to the load resistance multiplied by 100 is nothing but your percentage of regulation. Okay, there you may calculate, there are different tables are there in our laboratory. There you can find out for the different types of values. So remember this expression, that is VNL, that you are calling as VNL, no load voltage minus full load voltage by full load voltage into 100. Okay, this is nothing but your percentage of regulation. Okay, see, this is IDC, this is 2 Vm by pi, how you got the IDC into RL in the denominator part. Now previously we were having this. From this, you may going to get the IDC by RL. IDC value also here. See, this is, stick to this one. This is nothing but same IDC value. IDC into RL value. Right, next one is a form factor. Now, form factor is nothing but RMS value to average value. Already, you know, what is RMS value? By root 2, this is RMS value of full wave rectifier. Average value is 2m by pi, that is 1.12. This is your form factor of your full wave rectifier. Okay, what is the peak factor? The peak value to RMS value. The peak value is maximum is Im only. RMS value Im by root 2. The total you are getting Im is going to be cancelled. That is the root 2 is 1.414. This is the peak factor of your full wave rectifier. What is the peak inverse voltage? Now in case of half wave rectifier, only half peak is coming. That's why the maximum value is nothing but your Vm. In case of this, it is a double of your Vm. This Vm as well as this Vm. Completely you are going to get peak inverse voltage is 2 Vm. This is the peak inverse voltage of your full wave rectifier. That's it. Now I hope this full wave rectifier is, it is following the half wave rectifier. Now if you remember the half wave rectifier analytical part, the same thing for the full wave rectifier. Now almost 95% it is similar. The only change is nothing but we are considering only half of the signal in case of half wave rectifier. But here it is becoming the full wave and there only one current is there in half wave rectifier, that the total current is, that is the current due to the single diode. But in full wave rectifier, the total current is due to the two diodes. That is a diode D1 and diode D2. These two diodes at a time, they will not conduct. The diode D1 will conduct for the positive half cycle. The diode D2 will conduct for the negative half cycle. Now that's why you are combining these two currents. The total current I is equal to I1 plus I2. Just if you remember this simple, the total current expression, then everything is going to be clear. Now you can easily derive all the expression. Just to practice this half wave rectifier and full wave rectifier. And after completion, today I will share this slide as well as the last class video recording link also. Now once go through the presentation today itself, then it is going to be very clear to you people. Right? I hope it is very clear to everyone. Okay, now it's already 5-2. Now we will start our today's quiz. The today's quiz is completely on your full wave rectifier. Okay, the full wave rectifier, what are the expressions we are having? Based on that only we prepared the quiz. And you people can take the quiz within 5 minutes of time only. It will not take more than 5 minutes if you follow my class properly. Right. Now we'll move on to our quiz today. Okay. If you have the voltages. Now, we are not eliminating we are eliminating center tap transformer. Exactly. We are eliminating center tap transformer and we will put as a normal transformer there. There, see, input is step down only. Diodes will take only smaller voltages. Now, step down transformer we are using, that is compulsory, but that is not the part of your complete circuit. Because that is a normal transformer, the center tap transformer, these two are different. Right, now we are starting the test now. Madam, will you start the test?